The Minister of State for Higher Education, John Chrysostom Muyingo, today presented a statement before Parliament on expert courses as he was directed by Parliament yesterday. Muyingo has informed the House that every 5 years, all programs on masters, bachelors, diplomas and certificates are supposed to be reviewed every 5 years, and where they are not submitted for review, they are labelled as expired.
The National Council for Higher Education, in addition, assesses the quality and relevance of the program and its learning outcomes, as well as the teaching and learning methods. Institutions are required to resubmit programs for the reassessment every 5 years for those who are doing masters.
Muyingo says that programs that receive prior accreditation in accordance with the National Council of Higher Education minimum standards and regulations by the Council are valid.
As reflected on the National Council for Higher Education website, means that the program needs reassessment to establish whether the key aspects upon which accreditation was granted are still in place.
However, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Taiwa, asked the Ministry to direct the National Council of Higher Education to stop using the word expired and replace it with words under review to avoid causing panic.
Honourable Minister, you see, sometimes we love using strong words without knowing the impact they can have one day. Why use the word expired? If someone presented to you a product which had been declared expired, okay, it has expired, do away with it, start afresh, and yet you're just going to review.
The Attorney General, Kiryowa Chiwanuka, has assured Parliament that these programs are valid under the law, which has prompted Deputy Speaker Thomas Taiwa to give the Education Committee 1 month to investigate the matter further.
It is an administrative function that National Council of Higher Education is carrying out to review the courses. The use of the word expiry may have been a bit overboard, but that was their choice, and I think they're going to correct that. But under our law, there is no provision for expiry of courses. Courses are continuous. So the country needs to remain calm. There is no law that provides for expiry of courses.
Legislators reiterated concerns over the backlash that have exploded across the country following the directive by the National Council of Higher Education and asked the government to do the needful to mitigate after effects.
The rationale behind reassessment. In primary, at primary level, there is no reassessment of subjects. And you are doing it at the highest level. Once a course, a program has been accredited, and the university has a charter, the idea of periodical reassessment, in my view, becomes superfluous.
As a committee on education, we have been receiving several communications regarding these courses which they regard to have expired, and we have been interacting on our group. But we have also realized that the communication from Makerere University, if you also look at the communication from Chambogo University, and the word the minister has presented, they seem to be conflicting. So what we have decided as a committee is that we invite the Minister of Education and Sports and the relevant agencies, we interact with them tomorrow and possibly Friday, so that we go into critical analysis of the matter.
Parliament yesterday asked the Minister of Education to present detailed statements on non-accredited courses universities have been offering. This after students petitioned Parliament over a recent pronouncement by the National Council of Higher Education that over 1,400 university programs are expired. Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.